Tinkercad Sketch Revolve just got an awesome upgrade. I'm here to tell you about it, so let's get cracking. All right, so if you've never seen this before, it is Tinkercad.com. It is 100% free. You can simply choose sign in with Google. This is the homepage. If you click right here, you go down to all your designs. They are all saved to the cloud, and they're all private unless you choose to make them public. You can make 3D design circuits or work with code blocks. Today I'm going to create a brand new 3D design. In Tinkercad, we generally build with basic shapes. You can drag them out, stack them, build whatever you want. Once again, this saves instantly to the cloud. I'm going to name this SR2 for Sketch Revolve 2. I'm going to just show you real quickly that as soon as we've done that, it saves. If you back out to the Tinkercad dashboard, bang, that's what a project looks like. You can click here to make duplicates of it, test the version history, all sorts of cool stuff. And of course, if you want to get back into it, you just hit Tinker this. So I'm going to take our silly stacked objects and simply hit delete. If you have not seen my basic videos, I've got a bit.ly up here. It is a day one playlist that'll get you all the basics. Today, though, we're going to play with the brand new Sketch Revolve. When you bring this out, notice it fits a 20 by 20 grid. I'm dropping it right on that point. It lines up and it gives us a view that is vertical, with this being the bottom line. If you want to learn more about Sketch, there is a sweet built-in feature. It teaches you all about it, including what is brand new. You can click through these at your leisure. They've got awesome animations. Totally worth checking out, and as I said a moment ago, constantly updated. When you're done learning, you can simply hit continue to sketch. You can always get back to it right here. If you prefer my tutorials, you can use the bit.ly right here, or you can check the video's cards. So let's do a quick sketch. I'm going to start from zero, and I'm just going to do a straight line. Then I'm going to switch to the Bezier curve. Of course, the shortcut keys are faster. And then what you do is you click, hold and twist to make the shape you want. I'm going to make this bend out here a ways, then I'm going to do a straight piece, and I'm just going to stop right there. When I hit escape, check it out. We have just made a cool shape that's got awesome curves and a hole at the end. Do I have a need for this part? Absolutely not. Is it fun to make them? Yes, it is. Now here is the fantastic upgrade. You can take this now and you can cut it in half. Say I want half, I'm going to type 180 degrees, and bang, you have just made the cutout of that shape. If you needed it turned a different direction, you can quickly go over here and type 45 degrees and change how it rotates as well. Of course, you can lower the sides and you can upgrade the sides. You can also upgrade the quality. Friends, it is a fantastic tool. So many options. I am so excited to be able to create complex shapes like this using Tinkercad. Now, if you want to learn more about basic skills, I've got a few tutorials I'll put right here. You can find them in the cards or with the bit.lys that are provided. I do want to show you this. Once you've created something, you can click back to your workspace. You can click up here on the properties. I have now changed the name to Partial Revolve. I have filled in the design description. Of course, I put tutorial soon, and then I've added tags. My favorite tag is HLMT23. If you add this to any design, I will, of course, check it out and give you a reaction. You can also keep your design private. You can make a share link that you simply share with people that they can play with, and you can also make it public so the whole world can see it. If you want users to be able to modify your work, leave it as share alike. If you want them to just be able to see it, set it as no derivatives. I'm going to stay with share alike and simply save the changes. I will let you know that you can add images to explain the project. If I back out and we click on the gallery, of course, the first thing you see are the awesome staff picks. Remember, friends, if you see these and check them out, if it's one of mine, there would quite often be a tutorial, and those reactions are always appreciated. If you look down below, there are also other projects that are quite often worth checking out. Let's quickly shut off the staff picks, though, and I'm going to click on the grid so we can see more designs at once. As I wait for my design to show up, I like to click on these, check them out, and of course give a few reactions. Looks like a class somewhere is making fun pencil holders. That is fantastic. And someone even made a toaster. How awesome is that? While I'm in here, a quick shout out to Go Dangle and Landon for completing the awesome SVG paint project. Of course, you can follow that bit.ly to check it out as well. And after a few moments, here is the partial revolve. Of course, tutorial coming soon, and those reactions are always appreciated. All right, so a quick wrap up, friends. Of course, this is brand new. Make sure you play with it, explore it. If you make something awesome, make sure you tag it with HLMT23, and of course, I'll check it out. Don't forget to check out the videos I've shown here. They are both fantastic intros to Sketch Revolve and ways to use it. This new fractional trick will be fantastic for the train tracks. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, of course, you get early access to videos. Also, a massive shout out to my Patreon group. Love how it's growing. We are creeping up on 275 members. It has a messaging area where you can ask questions, gain skills. You can learn from all sorts of amazing tinkerers that are up there. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, hype a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.